been applied uniformly across all neighborhoods and types of property, this would be a budget my constituents could support. Unfortunately, this year's revaluation has had disparate impacts on the city's neighborhoods and types of property, and the impacts on my constituents are especially sharp. The second ward occupies a portion of Blackstone, College Hill, and Wayland neighborhoods. The taxes for single-family homeowners in these red neighborhoods will increase by an average of 11.5%, including 15.7% in the Wayland neighborhood. An 11.5% tax increase is clearly a very different matter from a 6% increase. In order to bring the city back from a Category 5 fiscal hurricane, the administration asks the city's stakeholders to agree to shared sacrifices of up to 10%, including all the unions, the city departments, and the mayor's overpay. In this framework, an average increase of 11.5% or 15.7% is not proportional. There is another way to measure the concentration of the tax increase in these three neighborhoods. There are 2,318 single-family properties in these three neighborhoods. Together, they represent 8% of the city's 34,829 residential properties, and in value, they comprise nearly 18% of the city's tax base. The budget will increase the tax bills on these people in a total amount of $2.6 million when compared to a total city residential increase of $7.2 million, including these neighborhoods. In other words, 8% of the city's property owners, who comprise around 18% of the city's tax base, will pay around 36% of the tax increase. This goes beyond what my constituents consider to be a fair share. As we all know, there was no conspiracy or evil intent behind the revaluation. Instead, it was performed by an established company using conventional methods in compliance with state law. With that said, Providence's property values have swung dramatically in each of the last three revaluations. Impacts on taxpayers in different neighborhoods depending on the year, for example, the 2007 one involved the south side of the West End, have been dramatic. Other states have procedures and rules to smooth out the rough edges of revaluations. For example, Connecticut phases in their effects over 5 years, while Arkansas places a cap of 10% on the maximum swing in values in any revaluation. There also are opportunities for internal reforms, such as adjusting the schedule so that taxpayers have more time to understand the effects of the revaluation, or by enhancing the oversight of the process. It is for this reason that I ask the administration to join the City Council in forming a committee to study the revaluation process, identify best practices from other jurisdictions, and recommend changes, both in internal procedures and recommend legislation at the state level. I'm pleased to say that the administration has agreed to join in this effort and to lobby the General Assembly to pass any necessary enabling legislation. I'm hopeful that we can improve our revaluations going forward, keep our property values more consistent, and thereby reduce the disparities that are such a problem in this year's revaluation. Thank you for your consideration.
Motion to the mayor.